Hello everyone, and welcome back to the Minecraft PACIFIST playthrough. My name is kmbles, and we have a lot planned for today. Adventure, some economics, even perhaps a little science. It's gonna be a lot of fun. In the previous episode, we built this barn, and got ourselves a diamond pickaxe. But we haven't had a chance to enchant it yet, so I think best use of my time today is to build an enchanting treehouse. I was originally thinking of building like a small little medieval enchanting tower, but a treehouse seems to fit the vibe of the valley much better, I think. Before we go any further, I should probably put some clothes on. Yeah, I'm actually a little nervous about this tree, as I've never built a custom tree in survival before. But I've had a practice, and I think it should turn out okay. Fingers crossed. Since we're pacifists here in this world and are forbidden from killing cows, I'm gonna need to rely on trading with villagers to buy all the bookshelves that we're gonna need for level 30 enchants. So in this episode, we're also gonna start trading some of our crops with the nearby farmers. I'll just craft up some composters so we can set the villager trades. This is our crop chest. I'm seeing a lot of carrots and pumpkins, so I think we've got a good start. Ah, drats. I waited too long. I'll let them sleep and we'll go visit them in the morning. Our fields here are a bit of an eyesore. I think the best thing to do is eventually just tear them all up and replant them over by the barn, which I think will bring a bit of life back to the valley. Don't look too closely over there at the function over fashion pumpkin patch. I'm not sure if I just made that expression up, but yeah, I'll get rid of these two soon enough, and in a few episodes we'll set up some kind of automatic pumpkin and melon farming. Coming up here in our first house, I believe this was the share house. Yep, good, so we should be able to recruit a couple of eager young farmhands to help us with our trades. Okay, hello you two. Hope you've been enjoying each other's company. Oh, they look like they want to escape. Not escape. They're not prisoners in there after all. Yeah, I promise we'll secure the village soon and let them free roam. We are playing ethical after all, apparently. Right, so we should be able to set their trades by putting these composters down. We got a carrot guy. Alright, we got plenty of them to trade with. And what about this one? I suppose I can return some of the wheat that I previously took from these villagers. Okay, I see now that I should have grabbed all those pumpkins before I came in. The importance of preparation. I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Okay, so it looks like they reached their trade limits pretty quickly, which is really unfortunate as we're just currently swimming in pumpkins, but I'll go try out some of the other villages and I'm sure these guys would have restocked by the time we come back. Hello in there. Here to conduct some trade. Okay, that is a terrible trade. Luckily we can... Yeah, I'm not gonna buy that. We already have a wheat guy, so I think we'll just replace his workstation and roll again, see if we can't get something better. Ah, carrots I can do. Alright, I'll go grab some more, maybe have a bit of a rest and be right back. Okay, these guys probably should have restocked by now. That's got to be the most satisfying sound in Minecraft. Oh wow, I didn't realize we're actually over level 30 already. It looks like we took too long with this guy and his trade reset. Oh, that's cool. It looks like maybe all farmers trade pumpkins. It's really handy for us, and will be a great source of profits once we get a pumpkin farm set up. Oh, but his trade's gone up to 9 pumpkins per emerald now. Per emerald. 9 pumpkins for an emerald. I think I must have done something to offend him. Look at all that tasty XP. Oh, buddy. Don't know why you don't like me, but yeah, I still like you. Have a piece of cake. Alright, so that turned out to be much more profitable than I thought it would be. We already have well over 100 emeralds. And, you know, I don't think it's going to be a problem at all to get enough to buy all the bookshelves that we need. But while we're waiting to trade again, let's head off back north and fill in a bit more of this map that we started last episode. With map in hand, we'll just craft up a quick boat. as well. I think traveling by donkey last time was probably more hassle than it was reward. And yeah, with a boat, we can probably uncover much more of the map. Bear with me here for a second while I check out this barn with some shaders on. Oh my god, it's really beautiful. I wish I could play like this all the time. Although I'm not sure my PC would be up for the challenge. Maybe I should look into making some computer optimizations. And away we go. Alright, well, you hopefully enjoy this helicopter flyover. I thought this would be a good time to just discuss what I wanted to achieve with this playthrough. With part 2 of the Caves and Cliffs update recently coming out and changing pretty much the entire Minecraft landscape, I wanted to jump into a let's play and explore as much of that new terrain as I could. Instead of staying in a single area, I'm going to spread my build out across the world, setting up small civilizations in different biomes, based on the different villager job classes. I'm hoping this will not only help us explore, but it'll really challenge me and help me improve on my building skills. Somehow I also managed to talk myself into attempting a pacifist playthrough, meaning we're only allowed to harm those things that would harm us, no exceptions. So no zombifying villagers to get cheaper trades, no killing animals for meat or leather, I'm not even allowed to fish. If you have any questions or ideas, please do that YouTube thing and let me know down in the comments. I'm really, really eager to hear what people think about this plan and in general, what they're thinking of the series so far. Thanks. Alright, it looks like we've come across some weird structure sticking out of the water there. Not too sure what it is, let's go in for a closer look. And I have no idea why I can't see below the water. I tried to get some better texture packs on, but I think I might have just made them worse. I'll look into it before next episode, apologies about that. Yeah, we definitely got some kind of man-made structure here. Okay, I see drowners, so perhaps this is just a drowner outpost. Oh, they make chilling sounds. Looks like a shipwreck behind him as well. These make a horrible sound. I mentioned earlier my favourite sound in Minecraft. This sound here may just be my least favourite. Now, I'm just trying to be really careful. I haven't come across any with tridents yet. I don't think we're geared up enough to take them on. Oh, it's one of those little children. Oh, there's two little kids. I've just broken into this poor family's house. I feel a little bit guilty. I'm not the bad guy, am I? No, I'm a good guy. It's the children who are wrong. Here we go, treasure. Ah! So close. These guys are persistent. They don't seem too dangerous though. Thankfully they're pretty slow. Just more of an annoyance. I just want to loot their homes and be on my way. And this sicko over here is trying to... looks like he's trying to take me out with his friend's arm. You live poorly. How do they multiply? How'd they get down here in the first place? So many questions. Let's see, was all that worth it? Hay and coal I don't really care about, but a buried treasure map, okay. I think that's worth it. I guess it all depends what kind of treasure they've got buried. This is my first time trying this trick out. Let's see how it works. That makes a lot of sense. Oh, we got ourselves another map. This is so handy. These are all magma cubes. Who's making all those sounds? Why can't I get down here? Oh my god! That was a jump scare. Oh, he dropped something special. I'll investigate that later. Alright, we'll have to dig our way in from the bottom then. Not much that we couldn't have just got back home. Don't even think I want that Thorn's leather cap. What are you holding? Oh, books, that's nice. And another buried treasure map. And paper. I think three treasure maps should do us for today. Oh, I almost missed this one hiding here. I guess I'll take the fishing rod, but seeing as we're playing pacifist, I don't think I'll get a chance to use it. I'm so excited, three treasure chests, or three hidden treasures that we gotta go find. And all that loot, are so productive. Let me just clean this out a little bit and then we'll go see what we can find on these treasure maps. Okay, this is one treasure map. And the same treasure map. Well, we don't need two copies of it. And that's the same as well. Ah, okay. Well, one treasure is better than none. Let's go track this one down then. Just on this sand ahead of us. I've always had so much trouble digging these things out. But thanks to Geminate, I learnt a little trick. If you just tuck your butt in underneath the X here, you should be able to dig. There you go, it's disappeared. You should be able to dig straight down. Oh, might help if we use the right instrument. Okay. And we'll just dig around here a little bit. It should only be three or four blocks down. Maybe we're standing on it. Oh, here we are. Okay. That is a lot of treasure. We'll take all that iron and gold. And we can eat that cod. A heart of the sea. I'm not sure what that is. And a little bit of TNT. Not a bad haul. Pretty happy with that. On my boat again. I can't wait to get back on my boat again. And something, something. And I've got to say, we've revealed quite a lot of this map already. And so far it's all the same kind of biomes. I'm yet to find a desert or a jungle or a badlands. Yes, another shipwreck. The promise of treasure is always very alluring, but when am I going to see a cactus or a parrot? I think tonight I'll sleep in style down with the fishes. I can't believe this is a thing. Oh, it looks like we have some jungle. Jungle vines, at least. This is great. We should be able to get some saplings and bamboo. God, it's gorgeous. The water's just turned a really light blue. Unfortunately, we still can't see below the surface, but I'm thinking there might be coral below us here. Oh, that really sucks. I was hoping to pick up some sea pickles or coral or something like that. Unfortunately, that sunken ship is just outside of our map, so we may as well leave it for another time.
Cookies, yum.
Wish I'd brought some shears so I could grab some of these vines, but I'll just try to snatch up a jungle sapling and we can start planting these at home.
Ah, looks like we finally go on. That shouldn't have been so difficult.
Okay, so we're starting to round back on home via land. Ah, the terrain here's pretty good.
Yeah, the water's still hideous as all hell. Wonder what this looks like with some shaders on.
Let me know if you find my constant use of shaders annoying.
I understand for some people it might take them out of the vanilla Minecraft experience. Oh my god, this looks so ugly by comparison.
Pretty sure that's our final tree sapling. Which means we can just grow all these trees at home on demand. I'm sensing expansion potential over here. Ah, cool, some white horses. I think I'd have to start catching those. Gotta get them all like Pokemon. So apparently we had this little village and mountain set up right behind our own house. Although it's gonna be outside of our map boundaries. I've gotta get home. I've been out for way too long. I can't believe this place has been right behind our base this whole time. Oh, this is so cool. We've got some llamas here just around the corner from home. Yeah, llamas are really cool. They're just like donkeys in that you can slap a treasure chest on the side of them. But with llamas, you can just lead one and others will follow, so you can make a caravan of them.
There she is, Llama Valley. We'll be home soon. I just wanted to get a bit of a look at our beautiful home from the nearby giant mountain. Oh, with a... seems to be occupied by a bee. Odd place for a bee to be. That's a tongue twister. I think it just wants to be the tallest bee in the world. It just may be. And we're back for some more trading. It's still just the two of them, I don't understand. They've got a spare bed and I gave them plenty of food. Why aren't they having any children? I think perhaps they're just throwing away the food in the compost. Could this be romance? Oh, didn't mean to interrupt. They do look at each other longingly. Just ignore me, pretend I'm not here. How are things getting started? I think you might need to be a little bit closer for this to work. Maybe if I get in the middle I can help out a little bit. Don't know why this is taking so long. Alright, you two, did it work? Is there a baby in the house? What's it gonna take to get you two to fall in love? Oh, that is definitely the look of love. I would recognize that look anywhere. Yeah, these two have definitely been bitten by the love bug. Maybe with a little bit of privacy, the sparks can fly, the magic can happen, the baby can materialize out of thin air. Alright, when I come back, I expect babies. Lots of them. Alright, it's finally my favorite part of the episode, the build. I've decided that this is probably the best spot for the treehouse. If we just clear out some of these trees, other trees in front, I think we'll have a great view of the forest there. And also if we turn around, we can see my starter house, the village, and importantly, the great llama statue. I think we probably have enough wood for the build. However, what we have in wood, we severely lack in leaves, and I suspect we'll need close to 1,000 blocks, maybe even something like 20 stacks. So I'll just craft up a few shears and head into the forest to grab some. Okay then, we have the wood and we have the leaves, but we haven't done any science yet. I've been thinking I might want to use some moss for this build, so what if we can kill two birds with one stone? Without actually having to kill any birds because we're pacifists. My idea is we grab this moss and bone mill it down in the diamond strip mine. Will it remove away all that deep slate, revealing the juicy diamonds behind? Only science will tell. This is my new mine entrance. I'm not sure if you guys saw it last episode. This might be the place where I put the forge. What do you think? I could put a suspended building down there, held on by chains. Obviously add a lot more lava. Maybe take away these torches to make it a bit more risky. But still find ways to protect the villagers. Alright, now I dug myself this little spiral staircase here. No, this is just a Y16 iron strip mine. Nothing too exciting. All the juicy stuff's a bit further below. If you come with me down these stairs, mind your step. Just a little further. Alright, torches indicate something special. And you know what it is? Look, I found, I think this is an iron ore vein. Iron ore mixed in with tuff. So, I've left it for the time being, until I have fortune in my pickaxe, but I don't know, this might be the forever source of our iron. No more iron shortages. Okay, let's get science in. Can we turn deep slate into moss, making this whole process looking for diamonds so much quicker? Let's try down here. Okay, here we go. And... Alright, obviously right-clicking doesn't seem to be working. I think perhaps the moss block needs air above it. That's better. Although it only got us two moss blocks. Test 1 was a fail. Let's try again. Test 2, a fail. That's disappointing. At this point, I think it's just quicker to use a pickaxe. Alright, I've been playing for hours and I really need to get started on this build. At this point, I'm not sure I really want to deep down, you know. I say I want to, but I know how difficult it's going to be. And I know how worried I am. I figured since we're building an enchanting treehouse, or a treehouse for enchanting, we may as well have enough ingredients for an enchanting table. So as long as this guy can leave us alone. I'm trying to become YouTube famous here. We'll just head down here and grab some of this obsidian for our enchanting table. And then, I promise, we'll get back to the build. Oh no, I lost it! That's why I brought the bucket. Alright, we'll just grab a bunch more and then head back up to the surface. Now, I wouldn't be much of a Minecraft scientist if I didn't test this moss thing on stone. Science has spoken. Let's go home. It's important to decorate your house. Okay, so we're all stocked up on leaves. We've got our wood. Nothing else can keep us from this treehouse. Let's get started. Okay, I'd say that's done. Really happy with this build. Looks gorgeous. Hey there, you want to come protect my treehouse? Yeah, we got our first wolf. Treehouse done, except now we need to go find some bookshelves from a librarian. The village is looking pretty nice from up here. The treehouse is looking nice, but I think some of those leaves need smoothing out. We can do that between episodes. Okay, so there's our house over there. We're just back at this village that we spotted on our adventure earlier. That's a nice little mountain range. Yeah, we'll just go have a look around the houses and see if we can't find a librarian somewhere. Yes, we're in luck. All right, let's head inside. It doesn't look like anyone's home. I think we can just take this lectern and go make our own librarian. I got no need for a cartographer right now. Come on. That's it. I'll get you trading. Nice! Bookshelves, 9 emeralds. The Wikipedia did not lie. Where's this guy going? 15 bookshelves. Well, lucky he just locked his trade as well. We got them. Let's go back and get set up. Yeah, it's gonna make it rain bookshelves. Oh, I need to be careful not to lose any. We're back, little buddy. I'm glad you're looking after this place. And you have nothing to fear from me. Yeah, he likes that song. Oh, it's our local neighborhood pirates. They always seem to visit right after I finish the build. Wonder if they're impressed with this one too. I'd play him a song, but I think we gotta earn that first. Wait till we enchant. There we have it, level 30, efficiency 4. I'm not sure if it will show up in the replay, but yeah, I fell off the treehouse while building it and lost all my levels. Sadly, no enchanting today. The important thing is we have a full enchanting setup now, and we'll be ready to enchant once we reach level 30 again. Alright, girl, let's get him. Oh, don't hurt my dog! Oh no! I don't want it to die. Leave the poor dog alone! Oh, the poor baby! It took so many hits! I don't think I'll fight with her anymore. That was so scary. Looks like we made it to the end of another episode. They say good things come in threes, and enchanting goes in trees. I'm really happy with how this turned out, even if it needs a little work around the edges. Thanks to everyone who stuck around till the end. To show my appreciation, I have a little surprise for you next week, but you gotta promise not to share it with anyone who hasn't seen the full episode. That could have been dangerous. If you get a holiday, I hope you all make the most of it and use the time to look after yourself and show appreciation to those around you. See you in the next episode.